A new study finds that despite popular belief, double mastectomies are not the most effective option for women with breast cancer. Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and you may recall last year, Angelina Jolie made headlines for publicizing her decision to get a preventative double mastectomy. Her reasoning, she said, in addition to having a family history of breast cancer, was that she was born with the BRCA1 gene mutation, which puts her at a very high risk for developing breast and ovarian cancer. A lot of people applauded her decision to have that surgery, and it certainly raised awareness about the fight for breast cancer. But was it really the right decision? And can preventative surgery actually prevent breast cancer? The answer may not be as clear as you think. The Journal of the American Medical Association published an article earlier this week, one of the largest studies ever conducted on this topic, stating that women with breast cancer who opt for double mastectomy don't actually increase their chances of survival any more than women who undergo a single lumpectomy, followed by radiation. Now, for those of you who aren't familiar, a double mastectomy is when they literally remove all of the breast tissue from both breasts, including the nipple and everything, to prevent the spread of cancerous tissue. It is an extremely painful surgery, not to mention the emotional distress that comes from losing such a fundamental part of your womanhood. It's devastating in pretty much every sense of the word. So typically, it's only performed in very extreme cases. But still, a lot of women do opt for it under the assumption that it could prevent future cancer. A lumpectomy, on the other hand, is usually performed on women who have a single localized tumor less than 4 centimeters in diameter. The basic formula is doctors extract the tumor, and then the patient undergoes radiation therapy for anywhere from 1 to 2 months. Surgically, it is far less invasive than a double mastectomy, but there is still a lot of scarring. Thankfully, breast reconstruction is available whichever route you choose, and the increased availability of those options could explain why the rate of double mastectomy has risen so sharply over the past 15 years. In 1998, only 2% of women with breast cancer opted for complete removal of both breasts. But by 2011, that number rose to 12.3%. So for this study, researchers followed 189,000 women in California with breast cancer for a period of 10 years to see who actually fared better from which surgical option. 55% of those women had lumpectomies followed by radiation, 40% had only one breast removed, and the remaining 5% had both breasts removed. After a 10-year follow-up, researchers noted that 16.8% of women who opted for a lumpectomy had died, compared to 18.8% of women who had had both breasts removed. Statistically, that is not a significant difference. But what's interesting is that women who only had one of their breasts removed actually had the highest mortality rate, 20.1%. The author of this study, Dr. Allison Kurian, says this doesn't mean we should discount double mastectomy surgery since it is still necessary for certain cases. But she does warn against women unnecessarily losing both of their breasts. Naturally, I would assume anyone undergoing that kind of surgery has carefully weighed all of the risks and benefits, but it's still interesting to see that something which seems like it would be far more effective really isn't better than the current standard therapy. While we're on the topic of devastating diseases, I want to let you guys know that I host another show here on Discovery called Test Tube, which is kind of like DNews, but for current events. Last week, we filmed an episode on why the world may never fully eradicate infectious diseases. In 2012, there were 223 reported cases of polio. In 2013, that number rose to 417 new cases, and 3/5 of those were in areas previously deemed polio-free. So if you're curious about that and you'd like to know more, just click the link on your screen to watch.